How's it going, everybody? This is Arsh, and a warm welcome to my latest Let's Play of Train Simulator Classic. Today, folks, we're going to be covering the Huddersfield line as we are taking a service from Leeds to as far as Manchester, Victoria, where a crew change will take place. We're using a Class 47-8, and we will be driving in the heavy rain as well. So this is my very first ever Let's Play on this add-on, and I want to do something a bit different, as I do like my Class 47s, and I do plan to make a scenario in the future for this route, which will use a Class 50, which version I don't know, as I was going to make it Steam Workshop compatible. Well, I may do two versions. I'll have to think about that. But anyways, what we got here is we are going to be doing a passenger run to Manchester, Victoria, and then a replacement crew will take over this train onwards to Blackpool North, as that's not included. This only runs from Leeds to Manchester, so that's more than enough. Without further ado, let's unpause the game and let's see what's in store for us then. Another Class 47 Greyhound is just passing us on the right, and I'll let you into a little secret as to why I call these Class 47-8s as Greyhounds, because of the long distance duties that they did before they were replaced in 2002, 2003 by the Class 220 and the Class 221 Voyagers. I don't think Greyhound is the official name for the Class 47s, but for these ones, but that's just my personal name that I've given them. Anyways, we've got the green, so without further ado, let's add some power and get our train moving. Then we will have a look around in the passenger view if there is one, but I'll do that once we arrive into Leeds station. Actually, scratch that, quite a nice cabin actually. Sadly, just one camera view, so let's quickly jump back into the cab. We better ease off, as we are coming into a 15 miles an hour restricted speed zone, as we are just coming into Leeds here, folks. rolling stock is from the British Rail era of the early 1990s, if not the late 1980s. The station itself is modern, and I think that applies to all the signals and stuff, so you can do modern day scenarios and stuff if you want to, and I may have a go at possibly downloading some scenarios from the Train Simulator community, as to be honest, it's been a long time since I have been in the mainland UK, because the last time I passed through Leeds was back in 2017, that was about 5 years ago, and in truth, I do like driving the Class 47 on this route, and I'm pleased it includes the BR or British Rail era stock, but I'd imagine it would be quite nice to take something modern like the Class 185 or the Class 68, the Trans-Pennine Express services from Leeds to Manchester via Huddersfield. Anyway folks, just boarding passengers, so we'll be on our way once the guard has secured the train and has given me the okay to proceed, buzzer, or whatever it is this train may have. Further ado, this one is going to be a non-stop run all the way to Manchester, Victoria. So let's get this train back into drive, get the brakes off, and get moving then. We have got the Mark 1D coaches, I think. There could be the Mark 1A or B's. I can't remember the type off the top of my head. But for those of you that follow my N-scale model train reviews, I do plan to get some VR era Mark II early coaches just to go with these stuff, well, these style of trains, because I do have an N-scale class whatever review to come up. Okay folks, we've got quite heavy rain here, and to be honest, I think I will have a go at doing this in a Class 50, as that's another one of my favourite British Rail era diesel locomotives, so I think they were used on cross country in the late 1980s before being transferred down to the southwest, the network service workings. So based on the model of the that old Class 50 that I have, so I don't know if it'll be released on the channel for the review, but I'm not going to say what number it is, but it's one of the large logo ones, okay, but I'm looking forward to doing a review of that Class 50, and upon reflection of that I may do a scenario that will actually use that Class 50's number, as it will be nice to actually have the opportunity to crash at class 50 along this brand new route. And at the time I've done this recording, Anglong just bought it, so definitely one I'm definitely wanting to give a try, as I do like these type of routes. Gotta be honest, folks. And got about 42 miles to go before we reach Manchester, Victoria. So I think that's our only stop, so this will be a direct run. By the way, as well, to mention, the duration of this scenario is 1 hour and 10 minutes, 70 minutes. So, I don't know what the train traffic will be like as we get into Manchester. We might have to queue to get a station platform. I have no idea. And this heavy rain should make it more enjoyable, as I do love a challenge, folks. Not gonna lie to you. And I may do some random thumbnails along the main line just to see if I can get a nice one for this let's play, as I tried to do them at the beginning or nearer to the end, but find a nice spot, I will do the thumbnail. Actually, I think I'll do here. Jump back in the cab, and that's a nice sweet looking screenshot. The Class 47 in the early 1990s going across the north of England. Perfect industrial estate in the background as well. A nice British scene and a perfect thumbnail for this let's play. And I really am liking this livery. This is the Intercity Executive livery. This Class 47, it's 47831. And if I'm not mistaken, the model and the cab view is from the former Virgin Trains park. So it's great to see this 3D model being reused, as it is one of the better ones from Dovetail Games. And in truth, it does show that they can make a great add-on this train simulator. So just going through Cottingley platform 2, and when I do more let's plays this route, I will be using the Class 142 Pacer and also the Class 158 diesel multiple unit that also comes with this route as well. And there is a couple of race scenarios that I will cover too. So I do intend to do lots of let's plays of this route for November. So if you like this route, I promise you are going to be in for a treat, my friends. Okay. So that's great. put a wee bit of power back on to come out those streamer speed. We're just passing through Morley here, folks. So, I'll do a warning horn. Okay, once we get back onto the 75 miles an hour zone, we can then open up the bar again. So let's open it up and focus back on the 75 miles an hour on the friendly side, but anyways, so let's open it up. would this route, this working, but using the class 47 with, would this be used by the class 68 and the Mark 5s operated by TransPennine Express, or am I thinking of another working? Please let me know in the comment section below, as I would like to be kept up to date with the newer locomotives and stuff. motor safely under the 40 miles an hour speed limit, and we'll use some braking just to bring us down to the upcoming 30 miles an hour. Once we pass Huddersfield, the speed limit will then increase, and a bit further out we should go back up to 75, so we should have another opportunity to crash this locomotive, which I'm enjoying, to be honest with you. No stopping at Huddersfield today, folks. That will be for another scenario. I'm just coasting. I will put the power back on just to keep this nice and safely at the 30 miles an hour speed limit, which we are under that now. So no overspeeding. So far, so good. That's 47 for Ash.
Thank you.
I've got a double yellow caution signal, so I think it's best we start slowing down. We're just coming up to Valley Bridge and start slowing down a bit more. So we don't want to run the red signals because that would be too bad, wouldn't it? Anyways, go to the side. I do like to try and drive pretty properly on these routes.
Just about to pass through Ashton
British trains and stuff, but well, I've been covering a lot of American trains and that. I do like the British trains and that as well, so it's nice to do something different and refreshing. I must say so myself.
Breaks up, that's the signal up ahead.
and have